This is about a troublesome encounter I had up in Maine with a very sorrowful young woman, and it's called Cut Girl. As if the pain were inseparable from the stagnant air, or the waves of gravity flowing from her coal black hair, her pale skin, the color of death, accenting a dagger-pierced nose and brow, her gloss black lips snarled beneath cold weapon-like eyes all blank in a dank day on a nowhere song sung like the random knife cuts up and down her arm. Scars that stitched the air with tragedy and carved reality into the solitude of her desolate mind. Those savage gothic eyes, passionately glaring in despair, soothed blissfully turbulent and radioactive. And every word she spoke madly adorned the sadness of her soul with enmity. For the enemy was conceptually me, and she was the number 7, dressed in black, playing chess with the devil like a character in a Bergman film tattooed to her left thigh. I wonder who promised her salvation, cashiering at a drugstore in Bar Harbor, Maine, where I stopped in for a beer all parched and worn, on a warm summer's day, dying as the sun wept crimson sighs settling behind dark magenta clouds on the horizon and bled. Its tears collected along the razor's edge when the red droplets flowered and flowed. And I know she wanted to kill me. I would be the revenge for a dark love crafted in her crazy dreams, yet I wanted to tell her that I loved her, but could manage only a mollified pity that felt dirty and shitty, so I had to get away. And if suicide stains the last cut, girl, I am hoping that this poem might somehow still keep you alive. Thank you.